Josh Peterson, Peterson Electric. We're out here in Denver, Colorado for a customer. The question today was that I have a 1950s home. What do I do about grounding? It's a great question. This house has copper in it, and the bathroom and the kitchen have been remodeled like in the 70s, so it's got grounds. Still got the cloth wire. The older parts of the home, like the living room and the bedrooms, do not have any grounds with the cloth wire. Now, how you know is you've got a two-prong outlet like this versus your three-prong like this. And so right here is your grounding on your three-prong. But that doesn't do you any good, because if you don't have a ground wire on this terminal going through the branch circuit to the panel and then to a ground rod, it's not going to ground. So technically, when you sell your home, if you're replacing these and you have no grounds, you need to put these two prongs back. But some people don't realize that inside of those little metal boxes is what we call a hickey, and it screws down and it chokes the wire. I have gotten in there before and found the ground wire and rewrapped it, and then once I screw these screws through this yoke of the device into the box, it grounds it and we put in three prong. In this home, half of it is and half it isn't. So the code in Article 210.8 states in the National Electric Code that you have to put in GFIs then right here. This will work as well. So as you can see, we put in a GFCI with a plastic extension ring and a plate. This gets a little costly. It can be about $30. And oh, keep in mind, this is the more inexpensive way of doing it than rewiring the whole house. The code does not allow you to run ground separate from the box if you're trying to get it passed through your city with a permit. I have done it in the past with wire mold, and it does work on the outlets, and it will pass for your rental housing inspections like Boulder and Fort Collins. But for Denver, as far as under their building permit, it wouldn't cover. But they will allow the GFIs with the tamper-proof design. So the newer ones have plastic tabs inside of all of the outlets. This is an older style three-prong and an old style two-prong. But the newer ones have a TR and there's plastic tabs. And that keeps kids from pushing in to a device to get electrocuted, such as maybe a screwdriver or anything, or a hairpin. So anyways, guys, thanks. I hope this helps you out. Give us a call if we can help you out. 720-641-8866. Thank you. Keep in mind, this is the more inexpensive way of doing it than rewiring the whole house. The code does not allow you to run ground separate from the box if you're trying to get it passed through your city with a permit. I have done it in the past with wire mold, and it does work on the outlets. And it will pass for your rental housing inspections like Boulder and Fort Collins. But for Denver, as far as under their building permit, it wouldn't cover. But they will allow the GFIs with the tamper-proof design. So the newer ones have plastic tabs inside of all of the outlets. This is an older style three-prong and an old style two-prong. But the newer ones have a TR and there's plastic tabs. And that keeps kids from pushing in to a device to get electrocuted, such as maybe a screwdriver or anything, or a hairpin. So anyways, guys, thanks. I hope this helps you out. Give us a call if we can help you out. 720-641-8866. Thank you.